This nature documentary was sponsored by Ring of Elysium. See now, the bare-backed, upright degenerate, spawning into his island habitat. His siblings are hungry for blood, and immediately start their first hunt. The degenerate, however, knowing he has sponsors to appease, makes his way to the ocean, in search of a randomly generated treasure chest, he instinctively knows, contains high-tier items. Upon approaching the shoreline, the wild degenerate empties his entire magazine to assert his dominance to other surrounding males. After scuttling into the ocean, the degenerate demonstrates his incredible underwater prowess with the help of a diver propulsion vehicle, although unfortunately, he quickly perishes only moments later without access to his user interface that had been requested to be turned off for a more cinematic tone. Set back, but not deterred, he continues his search for a treasure chest, and after finding a much faster mode of sea transportation, he cracks on with the speed of 1,000 tigers. In almost no time at all, the degenerate is able to find his prize and attempt to take it back to his dwelling for hibernation. Unfortunately, a pack of waterbound chads finds the degenerate and quickly ends his dream of getting a single fucking kill. However, getting right back on that metaphorical horse and straight into a fast as fuck vehicle, the degenerate once again tries to claim his rightful prize until he is temporarily derailed by a small hill. But with an iron will, this absolute force of nature pushes forward on foot until finally reaching the edge of the ocean. It is at this stage when the male shows signs of what experts refer to as rapid temporary metamorphosis, as he leaps into the air in a mighty display and deploys his wings that he admittedly forgot he had the entire time. Although, before he could finally get to his prize, he is challenged by an alpha male and is spectacularly defeated, despite his best efforts to discourage his aggressor. It is at this point when the degenerate decides to rethink his entire strategy and resolves to go soul searching to find answers. And after finally finding his lord and savior, the crab brave crab, he finally knew what he must do. Instead of trying to chase a few measly chests, the degenerate will now be hunting the ultimate prize, the pirate ship itself. And what better place to find a ship than the top of a lighthouse? Although unfortunately, it seems as if the degenerate didn't have keys, and the doors refused to be opened by his one life hack method. A few minutes, and another disappointing death later, it was time to enlist the help of a pair of experts.
Excuse me, do you know where to find the pirate ship? Is this where the pirate ship is, sir? Do you know where the pirate ship is?
با ماشین سوار شیم بریم اینجا گنگ ندیم یا بمونی بزنیم
بریم بابا برش بکن
بکن
As this plan also went horribly wrong, it was decided that he should simply use the one method that couldn't possibly fail. And after finding a computer, the degenerate could finally have even the slightest taste of his pirate ship dreams. Turns out, the pirate ship doesn't even show up unless during heavy rainstorms, and that boarding the ship will immediately deck the player out with a Terminator skin, a flintlock pistol, and a shit ton of other game-breaking loot. Not that this poor fuck will ever get to taste the sweet embrace of even marginal success. After a long hard day of being perhaps the worst pirate anyone has ever heard of, the degenerate thinks to himself that there probably isn't anywhere else in the world where he could find a battle royale experience that includes an underwater fighting feature, and that if he was part of some sort of hastily put together documentary on YouTube, then he would probably want viewers to know that the link to such an experience would be in the description. He then thinks to himself whether the audience would still find the joke funny when they've already been told exactly what would happen.